Okay, YouTubers, horsey people, this video was sent to me, and I'm going to tell you again, don't send me videos. Although I try to do some videos when I do it, I just get so many of these, and I see so many that people think I've either already seen them or whatever, but this happened to be one that I haven't seen, and I thought it covered a point that I covered before, so I just don't want to get inundated with 100,000 videos that everybody wants to send me their video, especially the ones where it's cruel to horses. I just can't watch them. This one is, where do I start with the ignorance? People, I've told you before, and if you have horse sense, when a horse gets free, when a horse gets scared, don't go to the outside fence. Go to the middle. Horses will always run to the outside looking for an exit. They always seek freedom, open movement from pressure. The middle of the arena, they're trapped, they're looking for release, they're running around the outside. I've said it before, I'll say it again. People that understand it will listen and know and believe it. And the rest of the 99% of the horse world who are idiots will still run to the stinking side of the fence when a horse is getting out of control. Alright, this is the stupid little buggy car racing, another stupid sport that I don't like any of them. Everybody always wants me to crack on someone else's sport, so now I'm going to piss off the people who ride these little carts. And you can go ahead and send me your hate mail about how it's such a great sport and how lovable it is and how the horse is and this is just a freak accident and you're being mean, whatever. All stinking sports where people do stupid stuff to try and win and they ain't got no business doing it and they're not horsemen and they're not horsewomen and they're not horse people. They simply have money to buy horses and buy the equipment and buy their way into their little events for their own ego issues. I am so tired of arguing with people about their sport is different. The only thing I care about in any horse sport is the horse. It doesn't matter if you get winning money or ribbons or ego involved or time, the horse pays. Period. I don't care which one it is. So don't write me your special email about how you love your sport and it's different. I don't want to hear it. If the horse is happy and there's no winning and it's just pleasure with your horse and spending time with your horse and working on your horsemanship and making your horse better, then I'm all for it. If it ain't that, which 99.9% of all horse sports aren't, then I don't have any use for it. I don't like it. I'm going to crack on it. I think it's wrong and I think it's full of idiots because people that understand and care about horses would not do that to a horse. They wouldn't put their horse as a racehorse. They wouldn't send it to a reining trainer. They wouldn't have it jumping over 14-foot jumps. They wouldn't have it jumping into creeks on footing. They wouldn't have it running around a stinking arena pulling a cart when the horse or the rider isn't trained and they don't know what they're doing. So all sports are BS to me. Are we clear? Are we crystal clear? You can't handle the truth. That's a little, if you ain't seen the movie. Few good men. Anyway, so here we go. These horses here. Now, I start with this picture right here because you see this guy right here. This is a man, everybody. So I don't want to hear anybody tell me how to never crack on men. This guy right here is the old horseman. He's been around horses his whole life. He knows what to do with horses. He's not afraid of horses. He knows he's in control and ain't no stinking horse gonna bother him. You know why he's here right now? Because the horse is here and he ain't here yet. Because when the horse gets here, this guy disappears. You don't see him again. Next time you see him, you see an ambulance, you still don't even see him. So this brilliant dude, this guy probably emailed me threatening to kick me and want to meet me at the airport and crap. Whatever, dude. I don't know you. What you did was stupid. If that bothers you, well, you shouldn't put it on video and you shouldn't bring your dumb ass in front of a horse that's running 60 miles an hour when he's scared and he's got blinkers or blinders on and he can't see what he's doing and he's scared and he's running and you're going to get in front of him. Okay? If you don't, boom, okay, there he goes. Oh, listen to poor people scream. Oh, I can't believe that. Oh my God, did you see that? That horse just ran over that guy and tried to kill him. That horse is crazy. Oh, come on, people. A freaking horse is running for 20 minutes scared to death. He's had all these people chasing him and scaring him and he runs over a dude and somebody in the audience is shocked. You hear the scream. You're going to hear it again when I play this video. Let me start this thing over. There's just so many problems here that I just can't even. Oh, my God. These videos just kill me. All right. See the nice guy in his horse? Oh, look. He's got a nice hat, Rick. Oh, look how pretty the horse. Oh, look how the horse holds his tail up. He's happy. Oh, look at his neck over extended. And they braided and they shaved his mane. Oh, Rick, they love that horse. I don't know why you're always cracking on them. Look how proud he looks. Look how strong and straight up. And he's holding the reins. And, man, that just takes such talent. That dude right there. Man, he's a horse whispering fool. He can sit back there and just, it's amazing. Yeah, okay, we'll see how amazing it is in a second. All right, let's start this thing. Oh, you know what? I gotta mute this. I don't wanna hear all this crap with the people. Here comes a lady. Oh, look at the pretty horse, Rick. How can you say this is mean, Rick? This is so nice. Okay, I wanna watch this. His horse is coming up here and you're gonna see, look at that overcocked neck. That's crazy, that's stupid, and that woman's all proud. Look how I'm a horse woman. Wow, I know. All right, here's this dude kicking. He's in trouble, see him leaning, pulling, causing pain, yanking on a bit. See, bits stop horses, people. See how this guy, this is the last time you're gonna see this guy too because he falls off here. Ready? Oops, no more rider. Gee. Okay, so. This horse is running. Look at the people running. Oh, my God. Look at this guy. He's going to jump over here. He forces the horse in and turns the cart over. Now the horse is running 10 times as fast because you got a bunch of idiots chasing him. Now the cart is up. If everybody went to the middle here and left the freaking horse alone, we'd probably be okay. Horse is panicking, scared. Look at the people waving their hands, trying to get in front. They forced the horse in the middle. The horse was running along the side. Now leave him alone, people. Now you've got him in the middle. Now what's going to happen? He's going to run another. He can't see. He's got stinking blinders on because of all these great horsemen that want to blind their horse because they think it helps them. So now I'm going to pull the reins and make the horse run in another horse. Oops. Now we got another horse running. Stupid freaking people just kill me. Now we're still chasing his horse. We still got idiots jumping in front. Nope. Everybody's in the middle. You ought to be worrying about your horse. Everyone else ought to be staying out of this. You stay out of it. See, look at this dumbass jump. Here's the horse guy that got, last time you see him, you'll see the ambulance next. So now this horse is getting blamed for running over somebody. He's a killer. He's crazy. He can't see. You got idiots chasing him. You got idiots running around trying to grab and hurt pain. You got him forcing him into where all the horses are. Let him run on the outside and stay. Now you got two idiots against the wall forcing him in the middle because they don't freaking know nothing about a horse. And they won't. Now you got a guy in a white jacket playing Superman chasing the shit. Runs him in another horse. Now we have another horse down because people can't leave the horses alone. Guess what? Now it spooked another freaking horse. Here we go. Now we got another one. All because of people and ignorance. Look at him. Now you have this horse scared to death with blinders on. Doesn't know what to do. Now he's turned over his cart. He's a nervous wreck. He's stabbing himself. Everyone in the audience is shocked and appalled and can't figure out what's going on. We got more idiots chasing him. They're still running after him. I cannot believe this. And all these people are horse people trying to be macho men. There ain't nothing but a bunch of idiots. There's a few women out there. But most of them are macho men trying to show how tough they are and how they're not scared. They don't know their own ignorance. They're trying to help and they're making it worse. And how many times does it take before somebody figures that out? Look how many times people raise their heads, raise their arms, and chase the freaking horse. Look at them. All they got to do is go in the middle and leave the damn horse alone. Oh, now we got another cart. Now we got more problems. Let me chase him some more because I haven't learned that chasing him doesn't work. I have not learned that out of all these horses. I'm still thinking that if I get in front of the horse or chase him, I can help. What a bunch of freaking idiots. This is your typical horse barn. This is your typical horse sport where you got a bunch of idiots. This horse is trying to follow that horse. If they just let that horse out of their horse, probably follow it. You got idiots that don't know what they're doing. Now, when you watch this, you're going to hear this lady on a loudspeaker going, "Leave, don't get away, get away from the horse. Leave the horse alone. Open the gate, close the gate. Don't go by." She's hollering all this crap on a speaker. Ain't nobody listening to nobody when a horse does this. You got a bunch of idiots. Look at this guy in the middle playing a bird. I hope he gets his ass run over. Those are the people that when they get run over, I go, "Good horse. You're an idiot. You do not jump in front of a running horse, people. I don't care how good you are. You just don't do it. The horse is scared. He doesn't know. He's not being bad. He's panicking. He's getting slapped. He's stepping on a bit. He's got this thing chasing him. His tail's up. He's nervous. He's got people screaming. He's got the lady on a loudspeaker screaming. He's got people in the audience going, oh my God, the horse is loose and he's running. Somebody catch him. Leave the horse alone. When you calm down and you mellow out, the horse will mellow out. Leave him alone. Stop chasing a horse. These idiots are going to call and write me and go, hey, how do you catch a horse that's run away? Stop chasing him, dummy. Leave. Now this guy's going to get, oh, now this guy's a real cowboy. He's got himself a whip. Oh, we got a lariat out there. Great. Ran a horse in there, tripped him, probably broke his leg. Why do they jump on this freaking horse? I got no clue. You've scared the shit out of him. He's panicky, nervous, and let the horse get up and walk. Now, what they're thinking, look how many people around this horse, people. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 freaking people. Are any of you got a clue or a brain in your head on what a horse is and how a horse feels trapped on the ground? Everybody's got to see. Look at Mr. White Legs with his shorts on. That's me out there on my life. If I wore shorts, my legs. Look at him. He gonna get over there like he knows something. Look at him. They're all getting. They're trying to take the harness off. Who cares? Let the freaking horse up. Now this guy's gonna. Oh, give me the halter. I know what I'm doing. Let me in here. I got a cowboy shirt on. Let me get a halter on this horse. Oh my God! What a freaking disaster! All caused by people. Now, most people are going to see this and they're going to blame the horse. They're going to blame the carriage. They're going to say those horses aren't. All the horse show people are going to go, those horses shouldn't have been in there because they're obviously not trained. And they went to an event that they're just too advanced because they think they're so good that it can never happen to them. This is nothing but a horse getting spooked. Horses get spooked. Horses get in trouble. Horses get into problems. People. Stupid humans are supposed to be able to help them prevent, see the problem. When the problem happened, make it less, correct it, ease it, lower the anxiety, lower the stress. No, hell no, not these people. You got 15 freaking cowboys out here wearing tennis shoes chasing horses around here because they all know what the hell they're doing. Why do they know? Because their wife's in the event, or they got a horse in the event, or they're a trainer, or they're... Let the freaking horse get up and leave it alone. That's probably Billy Bob, who's owned horses his whole life, that got in front of a horse earlier, riding away in the ambulance. The horse is gone. I have no clue what happened to the person that got ran over or to the horses. All I know is this was just a disaster, and it's all because of people. People, people. Stupid after stupid after stupid. Not one person did anything right in this. Maybe somebody sitting in the middle who was scared. Somebody scared would have probably been the best thing because they probably wouldn't have got involved. Stay out of it. This guy, totally wrong. He's going to get kicked. He's scared. He's not stopping his horse. He's pulling on both reins, causing a horse to brace. If he'd have pulled on one rein, he probably could have helped the horse. And, of course, the lady on the speaker is telling him, walk your horse, like he has any control. Now, you got freaking the meat packer out there who wants to buy the horse after they sell him because he's crazy. He's out there trying to catch a horse in his white cape. The horse is scared. Leave him alone, and he would run himself out and calm down. Of course not. You got the flapping beanie people with the hats and the cowboys getting in the horse way, chasing him into other horses. Right now is a perfect time for everybody. Don't move. Nobody move, and nobody does nothing to the horse. Leave him alone. Just leave him alone. But you can't do that because you got people that know. I got to catch him. I got to pull his mouth and take away his vision so he runs into another horse. I got to make this horse run another horse because I'm too stupid because I'm trying to help. But Rick, he's trying to help. I don't care when you try. I don't care what your intent is, and neither does the horse. You either do harm or you do good. And most times, see you, Billy Bob. Most times... Hey, how's that dirt? That dirt looks like pretty good dirt. Most of the times, if you stay out of it, you'll make it less. When you do what all these idiots are doing, you got people standing on a wall, not getting away from the wall, throwing paper, chasing them into the wall, chasing them into people. It's just unbelievable, the ignorance I see in this video. And I can guarantee you I am going to get, yo, Super Cape, somebody needs to trip his dumb ass. Hurt that damn horse because you're an idiot and you chase him with a jacket on. Now, you notice the cowboy kind of took his head away, made him go in circles and calmed him down. But he was in an ability to do that because he had the horse. This video just drives me nuts. You can watch it however many times you want. It just so sad that these horses were all being good horses, doing what they were told and what they were made to do. Not one horse had a choice in what happened in this arena. Only all the people who wanted to win their little ribbons and win their little trophies and make everything about the human and about the ego, that's the only one that mattered in this event. Not one horse got one thing out of this event except pain, damage, fear, confusion, broken legs, stabbed with gear, slapped, tore up mouth. That's all the horses got out of this. It just irritated. Somebody hit the ground. How many people hit the ground here? Not enough. That's how many. Because in my book, every one of them should have had their butt ran over. Stay out of it and leave the damn horse alone. Ugh. All right, people. If I told you once, told you a million times. Cowboy knew how to get out of the way. Hey, maybe he has a brain. Maybe that hat just ain't for looks because he knew how to get the hell out of the way. Oh, my God. Now, when this horse is doing this, every other horse ought to be exiting. You ought to be seeing this as an opportunity to get your horses out. And I think they do this when you listen. They finally open a gate and get rid of a few. After all the carnage of the dead pulleys, this horse still hits and stabs. And, I mean, it's just horrible. These horses are so scared right now. Look at this bird man. Run his ass over. These horses are total. This is what you call when a horse goes into fight or flight. He's in his flight mode right now. He's scared. He can't see. He's trapped. He's pulling something. Something's chasing him. Crazy people are chasing him. This is so easy for me to see all the multitude of things that are going into this horse that's making this horse more crazy than it is. And not one of these freaking show people who want to tell me how great shows are has a clue or understands a horse and how to help a horse. All they know how to do is how to dominate, bully, pull a horse around with a bit, make him listen, collect the awards, and brag about how great they are because their horse won a ribbon. That's my spiel on this stupid sport, whatever it's called, carriage, pulley, tractor, whatever. All these horses had to pay because of all these people's ignorance. I'll put a link in the description. You can watch it if you want. It just irritates me. Poor horse. All right, we'll end that there, freaking people. Buddy and Mr. T, go kick somebody for me. We'll end that there.